Good morning. Good morning, everyone, and welcome to St. Mary's Church for our all-age service this morning. Welcome if you're visiting us for the first time. Welcome especially if you're part of Henry's baptism party. It's great to have you with us as well. You're very warmly welcomed to St. Mary's. We're looking forward to baptizing Henry a little bit later on in the service. It should be a fantastic time for us as a whole church to join together to celebrate something so positive. My name's Alec. I'm one of the ministers here at St. Mary's, and it's a joy to lead the start of our service. Later on, I'll be handing over to some of our 0-18s team, and they'll be leading us through some other parts. As you can hear, there's some shakers around in the building. If you've got little ones who might like a bag of goodies to occupy them, they're just at the back. If you want to grab some, you're very welcome to. And if you do need to nip out for the toilet or anything like that, it's just through the door at the top, my right, your left at the back, just down to the side there. I'm going to start with a reading from Psalm 98. Sing to the Lord a new song, for he has done marvelous things. His right hand and his holy arm have worked salvation for him. The Lord has made his salvation known and revealed his righteousness to the nations. He has remembered his love and his faithfulness to his people. All the ends of the earth have seen the salvation of our God. We join and celebrate that together this morning, the salvation that God brings through the Lord Jesus Christ. The words will come up on the screen for us to follow along in our songs and also join the baptism and prayers. Otherwise, you are welcome to join in where you're able to. Please feel free to stand for songs or sit if that's more comfortable for you. We're going to begin with our first two songs. But Beckett is going to come and run through some actions for us first.
I thought you were going to do the actions, Alec, because I know how much you love them. Ow, where's best for me to be without tripping over? This is the time to get your shakers and your ribbons out if you want to. Or, if you're feeling brave, this is the time to learn some actions. We're going to start with a song called King of Me, and I believe we might have the chorus to put up. And it says, my God's the king of the giants. My God's the king of the lions. My God's the king of the creatures of the deep. And my God's the king of me. If you can't get it, don't worry. Join in as best as you can. Use your ribbons and use your shakers. No, would you like a shaker?
My God's the king of me.
Together as a church and able to do this again. We've not had a baptism for a while, so it's a real privilege. Thank you everyone who's come to celebrate this with us, and the family and friends for coming as well. Henry's looking excited and happy, which is good. Let's hope that lasts us through the baptism and the water. I'm sure it will. It's good. If you want to stand forward a little bit, I'll move that for you. And if we can just bring up words on the screen for us. Let's just think for a moment as I read these words about what baptism is, why we have baptisms. Children who are too young to profess the Christian faith are baptized on the understanding that they're brought up as Christians within the unity and the family of the whole church together. As they grow up, they need the help and encouragement of that family, so that they learn to be faithful in their public worship, in their private prayer, to live and trust God, and to come eventually to confirmation. Now, parents and godparents, I'm going to ask you a question now as we gather. You've brought Henry for baptism today. He chiefly depends on you for help and encouragement that he needs. So are you willing to give it to him by your prayers and by your example and your teaching?
I am willing.
Thank you. People of God, everyone here today, will you welcome Henry by your prayers and example and support him and his parents in the way of Christ.
Because the help of God will be with us.
That's good. Those who bring children to be baptized must affirm their allegiance to Christ, their rejection of all that is evil. So it is your duty as parents and godparents to bring up Henry to fight against evil and to follow Christ. Therefore, I'm going to ask you these questions, which you must answer for yourselves and answer for your children as well. Do you turn to Christ?
I do turn to Christ.
Do you repent of your sins?
I repent of my sins.
Do you renounce evil?
I renounce evil.
May Almighty God deliver you from the powers of darkness and restore in you the image of his glory and lead you in the light and obedience of Christ. Amen. You've brought Henry for baptism. So you must declare before God and the church the Christian faith into which he is baptized and in which you will help him to grow. So you must answer for yourselves and for these, for all your children. Do you believe and trust in God the Father, the source of all being and life, the one for whom we exist?
I believe and trust in him.
Do you believe and trust in Jesus, the Son, who took our human nature, died for us, and rose again?
I believe and trust in him.
Do you believe and trust in God, the Holy Spirit, who gives life to the people of God and makes Christ known in the world?
I believe and trust in him.
This is the faith of the church. We'll all say together, this is our faith.
We believe and trust in one God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Faith is the gift of God to his people. By faith we are buried with Christ in his death and share in his resurrection. That's what baptism symbolizes, into the water and coming out. By faith we are reborn of the Spirit. So may those who are baptized in this water come to faith in Christ by the power of the Holy Spirit and learn to live steadfastly in the risen life of Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. Henry, do you think you'll come to me? Hey, Henry. Oh, we can have a shake. I baptize you in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. I sign you with the cross of Christ, the sign of Christ. Do not be ashamed to confess the faith of Christ crucified. We say together,
I proudly claim as a disciple of Christ against sin, the world, and the devil, and remain faithful to Christ to the end of your life.
Alice, you can be brilliant. How big? Good girl. Well done. Oh, very good. You can keep that in your hands for the service. Well done, Henry. That's fantastic. So let me just pray for us as we continue. May God pour upon you all the riches of his grace, that strengthened by the Holy Spirit, you may increase in faith and love, and grow to the full stature of Christ in the fellowship of the people of God.
Amen.
There is one Lord and one faith, one baptism. By one Spirit, we are all baptized into one body, the Church. Let us welcome Henry together.
We welcome you into the fellowship of faith. We are children of the same Heavenly Father. We welcome you.
Shall we give him a big round of applause? Now for our baptisms here at St. Mary's, what we like to do is give you a candle and a Bible. And those two things you can hold for if you want to now. You might have to do a bit of wiping down later. We're going to present you with a Bible and a candle because those two things symbolize Jesus, the light of the world, and Jesus, who is the Word of God. And it is faith in him into which we are baptized. Steve and Kathy are going to come up and present those to you. You don't have to keep the candle burning all through the service, don't worry. We have one of these Bibles at home and it is now in shreds because the more you read it, the more fun they have learning about Jesus and the more the book gets tattered. But enjoy that, and it's a sign of bringing children into the Christian faith from the very earliest age as we spend time with God's Word and with them. So let's give them one more clap as we continue. Fantastic, and thank you all for joining in so enthusiastically as well. I'm going to hand over to Kat now. I remove the water obstacles.
Morning, everybody. How we doing? Okay, so in a minute, I'm going to ask the Wild Women of Wales to come and talk to us to read from the Bible. But first, I just wanted to let you know what we're doing this year in our all-age service. We finished looking in the book of Luke, and this year we're going to look at the whole of the Bible. Now, we're not going to read it page by page, cover to cover. I think that would take longer than what we've got time for. Instead, we're going to look at the big story of the Bible. Now, I don't know how many of you have actually read it before. I don't know if you've got one. I don't know if it's gathering dust in your house. I don't know if it's part of everyday life. I don't know if you've got good intentions to read it, but we're praying that together, as we trace this big story through the Bible, that we'll learn together. Now, the Bible's actually, thank you, not one book. It's 66 books. And it's written by like over 40 different people. Some of them are kings. We've got fishermen in there. There's a doctor. And it's written in different languages. And it's written over this really long time, like over 1,500 years. But through the Bible, there is this thread, this one story that goes all the way through from the beginning to the end. And it's a love story, not a romantic, mushy kind of story, but it's a story about a God who has a sacrificial, a giving love, an unconditional love for his people. And that's what we're going to look at. Now, the Bible has a start and it has an end, but God's story keeps going. So it means something for us today, and that's what we're going to look at. So, since this is the first month of the series, we're going to look at the very beginning of the Bible. And we need the Wild Women of Wales to come read it to us. Let's have her up.
Well, hello, Mother Da. Oh, Christ, it's so lush to be here. Do you know, it's ages since I was last doing this. You've been remembering some of the Welsh words we've learnt already. We've learnt bora da, good morning. We've learnt pnawn da, good afternoon. And nos da, good night. Croeso, welcome. And we've also learnt Iesu Christ, Jesus Christ. And we're going to learn one more word today. very big. Dune means God. And you know, when I was a little girl, I used to go to a Welsh chapel. And in the service, all the children had to come out to the front and turn round and look at the congregation, at all the mummies and daddies, and say a verse that they had learnt in the week. Oh, a verse in Welsh, of course. And if you were very little, you learnt a very short verse. And then as you grew bigger, you learnt more and more complicated verses, maybe a hymn even. And the very first verse that I learnt was about dew, about God. And it was, dew, carried you, dew, carried you, God, carried love, you is, dew, carried you. God, love is, or like we say in our English Bible, God is love. And you know, all those verses I learnt as a child, I remember them, well, most of them, I still remember. Anyway, let's see what's occurring in the Bible today, shall we? And let's see what dew, what God's been doing. And as Kat said, it's from the very first book of the Bible, Genesis, from the very first chapter. And we're going to start at verse 26. Excuse me. Then God said, let us make mankind, that's people, let us make mankind in our image, in our likeness, so they may rule over the fish in the sea and the birds in the sky and over all the livestock and all the wild animals and over all the creatures that move along the ground. So God created mankind in his own image. In the image of God, he created them. Male and female, he created them. So he made us all. And God blessed them. And he said to them, be fruitful and increase in number. Fill the earth and subdue it. Rule over the fish in the sea and the birds in the sky and over every living creature that moves on the ground. So God has given us all these animals to look after and rule over. And then God said, I give you every seed-bearing plant on the face of the whole earth and every tree that has fruit and seed with it. They will be yours for food. And to all the beasts of the earth and all the birds in the sky and all the creatures that move along the ground, everything has the breath of life in it. I give every green plant for food. And it was so. I don't know if any of you have been watching these David Attenborough programs about plants, or how wonderful all those amazing plants God's created for us. And God, listen to this. This is very important. God saw all that he had made, of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Okay, so we've had a bit of the beginning of the Bible read to us now. There's a couple of things that happen in the bit before our Wild Woman of Wales reading. Just taking a few incidentals, like the creation of everything was made in the first 25 verses, and then in verse 26, we pick it up with the creation of people. Now, I'm not going to get into it this morning, the exact ins and outs of how the world was made. Was there a big bang involved? Was it a literal 6 days? Was there space in between those 6 days? How long was an actual day? Those are all brilliant questions, but I don't think that's what the emphasis on this chapter is really about. To give you a little bit of perspective, the same guy in the same book gives 12 chapters to a guy called Joseph, you know, the one with the amazing Technicolor Dreamcoat. He gets 12 chapters. The creation of the world gets one chapter, one page. So I don't think that we're really meant to focus on the ins and outs of how the world was created. I don't think it's a question about how. I think it's a question about who. and we learn about this God who existed before anything else did. He has always been, and then he is the one that brings everything into existence. And if you read those first 25 chapters, or if you look at nature, think of those David Attenborough programs. I was going to bring in a plant, like a house plant, but we kill ours, so I don't have anything to show you in that respect. But if you look at nature, you look at the way that things are created, we learn a lot about who God is. And it's revealed in those first 25 chapters as well. Woo! God is a God who's creative. He is a God who loves variety. He didn't just make daffodils. He made like 400,000 varieties of flowering plants, according to Google. He is a God who likes detail, who likes diversity. He is a God who likes order. And he is a God that is powerful. It says in those first 25 chapters, God said it, and it was. God said, let there be light. And there was light. Can you imagine having that much power? How great would that be in the house? Mummy said, let the living room be tidied. And it was. Like, that would be amazing. God is a powerful God. He says it, and it comes into being. Those verses tell us about who God is. And then in the bit that we had read out there, we learn about who we are. We learn about who we are. And the Bible tells us that we're made in the image of God. Now, the small person here doing cartwheels and jumps in front of you, she is my daughter. And many folks talk about how she is my mini-me. She looks like me. She acts like her daddy, not like me. We are the image of God. We're the spit of God. We resemble him, not in our physical appearance, but more to do with our nature and our characteristics. So we image him mentally and morally. So if you've ever solved a maths problem, if you have ever created a story, if you've ever named a pet, if you've ever painted a picture, you are showing the image of God. And we're to be like him. We are like him morally as well. Now, God is 100% good 100% of the time. Spoilers for next month's talk. We are not. We are not 100% good any of the time. But in the same way that God is upset and angry by the bad stuff in the world, we too get upset and angry by those things. We have a conscience. When we lie, we feel, or do something wrong, we feel guilty about it. That is us bearing God's image. That is us resembling God. And I very briefly want to talk about three areas this being the image of God affects in our life today, and what it says in the Bible about those. So we're going to think up, we're going to think down, and we're going to think around. So first is up. We are made in the image of God. Nothing else in God's creation is made in the same way. We are special. We have an extra value that nothing else that God made has. That makes us special. We have a privileged position with God. We are made to be in relationship with him. He created us to know us so that we can know him and we could love him. We could share in this creation with him. Now, my girls at home will spend a lot of time making Lego worlds with their Duplo and their Lego and everything else. It gets really intricate. Everything looks great. Then they get distracted and they go off and play with something else before they've actually played with what they have made. That's not God, okay? So he's made the world and he hasn't then just left and gone off and done something else. He is in his world with his people. In chapter 2 of the same book, we learn how he walked and he talked with Adam and Eve. He wants a relationship with us. He wants us to know him. He loves us with this love that is eternal. It goes on and on and on. It's unconditional. It's not based on who we are or what we do. He just loves us, and that love doesn't change. And he wants us to know him. So because we are made in his image, we have this up relationship, a relationship with God. And because we're made in his image, we also have this down relationship, this relationship with the world. In those verses, we're told that because we're made in his image, we've got a job to do. We are called to take care of this world that we live in. We're told to grow and create. We're told to grow families and communities. We're told to grow food. God gives us this world in part to provide for us. The verses tell us that we've got plants to eat,
fruit to have. In some chapters later, meat gets added into the mix as well. And we're told to develop and invent and create in the same way that our God does. We're given this privileged position to rule over the earth and everything in it with care and concern for this world. Now, I don't know if any of you guys have got these in your house, Playmats, one of our favourite toys ever. Probably most favourite with my husband. They're like little plastic tiles that are magnets and they stick together. Sometimes Rich lets the kiddos play with them as well. He makes these brilliant like castles and structures with them. And if Ailey's really fortunate, she gets to join in. But that's a risky business, isn't it? So her adding to his creation goes one of two ways. So either it makes it even better and she comes up with new fantastic ideas, the bluey characters get thrown in there as well, and it's fabulous. It can also end up with everything crashing down as well. It's a risky business for God to allow us to work and partner with him in his creation. But that's what he does. He's given us a job to look after this world. We've got a relationship up with God, we've got a relationship with this world, and we've also got a relationship around with each other. Now, to really understand what it is to be made in the image of God, we need to take a couple of minutes to think a little bit more about who God is. And so it came up on those words in the baptism. We talked about one God in three persons, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. So God is one God, but three in one. Now, this is a concept that needs a whole talk all in itself, and we're not going to do that now. And it's also something, even if we did have a fantastic talk on what it is for God to be three in one, our brains can't quite hold that concept because our God is a great big God. We sung about that at the start. But I've got two illustrations that help my mind just kind of like cope enough with this idea to help me move on with what I want to really say about this. So instead of thinking 1 + 1 + 1, which is 3, think 1 × 1 × 1, which is 1. That's as far as my maths knowledge goes. But I've got a better one to help us think about it. Jubal's chocolate, and now you're all wishing you brought some as well, aren't you? This Mars bar is made up of 3 bits to it, isn't it? It's got the chocolate bit round it, it's got that caramel bit in it, and it's got the squishy bit as well. It's the one Mars bar, it's got 3 bits to it. Now, for it to really work, you have to imagine that the chocolate and the caramel and the squishy bit are fully this thing all at once, and that's when your head freezes a little bit. God is 3 in 1. The reason that we need to know that is to understand ourselves better as well, because if we are made in God's image, then we are made in the image of a relational God. God didn't make us because he was bored and lonely. Hey, bubs. He was fine by himself because he is 3 in 1. He is a relational God, and each member of himself is a perfect community providing for each other, and there's love there, and it's wonderful, and he was fine by himself. But he made us because he wants us to know him and to experience his love. But he made us to be relational. It means that we're meant to be around other people. We're meant to be around folks. That's why the past 2 years have been so hard. As necessary as it might have been, we weren't created for social distancing. We weren't created for isolation. We're meant to be together. It's one of the great things about having this baptism, the togetherness aspect of it, sitting here and saying together, yeah, we're going to support these guys. We're in this together. We're a family. God has made us to be together. God has made us to be in a relationship with him. God has made us to look after this world. And God has made us to be with each other. Now, that's great. That's a bunch of information there. Fabulous. What's the point then? Well, Cara, my other one, who's around here somewhere, she had a birthday last week. And one of the presents she got was this wooden cafe. And it's really cool. It's got all these little bits. It's got all these little bits to it. And we were left over, after fitting everything together, with these two poles. Could we find where they should go? We're trying them in all different places. We had no idea what their use was, what the point of them was. We were getting ready just to shoot the extra pieces and chuck them. And then we did that thing where you go, oh, there's instructions in the box too. Let's have a look at what they say. Turns out they're little things for holding the mugs. We would have been fine without it. It's much better with it.
It made a difference knowing how it was put together by the people that made it. It can make a difference to us knowing how we are put together and what our purpose is, I got it, by the one who put us together, the one who made us. The more that we know and understand who God is and how he has created us, the more we make sense here and now and in this world. So it doesn't matter what the world says, but if we know that we are made in God's image, the value that we have, the love that God has for us, what difference that could make to our lives? Knowing that we were created for a purpose, knowing that we're created to be with other people, what difference that could make? So cracking start to the story. I'm going to say a prayer for us. Father God, I thank you that you are this powerful creator who loves us, wants to know us, and wants us to know you. Father God, I pray that you would help us to know how much we're loved by you. I pray that you'd help us to understand our purpose, and I pray that you'd help us to do that together. Amen.
Okay, this is the point in the service where we just have a little bit of competitive fun. Anybody like competitive fun? We've got a couple of super competitive teenagers here and their brother and sister. Anybody else got brothers and sisters that they're super competitive against? So Ritika, Rakeel, where's Rakeel hiding? There he is, he's hiding there. You're going to come out the front. I'm going to pick you two adults that are super competitive as well. So we need super competitive dance that might have done Rapido. Do you know the game where you get given a word, you have to model it, the other person, your super competitive teenager, you get that table, here comes this one, and you have to try and guess what it is by the modelling, and then you run to the back and you get the next word. Who's played that game? Okay. Anybody, but nobody's played it. Steve, you're not playing it. Oh, you're rubbish at it, okay. Well, somewhere on this table was a piece of paper before that seems to have gone. Ah, you've got it, Kat, that's okay. Now, over there's Becca and over there's Kat. They've got three words on that bit of paper, but I do need somebody who's going to come and join this team. Who's going to come and join? They all shout at once. Super competitive person. Mr. Ham, do you want to come? Yeah? And I know what would be fun. We'll have super competitive Mr. Ham on this team and super competitive Mr. Farrell on this team. Now, they don't come any more competitive. This is Richard, who has been absolutely slated this morning in the service already, because this is Kat's husband. You know, the one that doesn't let the kids play with toys. The person who first said these words to me, Malcolm, it's good job that God loves you, because the rest of us think you're an idiot. This is all true. Okay, so now there's three words. Now, I'm going to give you a clue. They are words to do, sort of to do, with what we've been talking about, the creation of the world. So there is an animal, there is a specific type of fish, and a specific plant. Okay, so now what you need to do is you need to go and find out what the word is. Then come and model it. You need to find out what the word is. Go to the back, and then you're going to come and model it. And you've got to guess. As soon as you guess, you run to the back and get the next word. Comprendez-vous? Thank you. Another French speaker in the audience. That's good. Okay, so here we go. You ready? Are you ready to go? Go. Here they come. Now, see how they get on with this. Now, the colours aren't going to be particularly helpful in this, but we are looking. The first one is a type of animal. Okay, so keep guessing. I mean, I'm sure at the moment it's been split into three parts on this table. This is a single animal. It's not a crocodile. No, it's not quite a nice guess. But guess a bit quieter, okay, because you don't want to give away the answer to this team. Because you can. There's a little bit of talking going on here, a little bit of muttering underneath his mask. It's not... that's a really good one, Richard. Well done. Just get his ear right. It's not a giraffe. It's not a giraffe. It's got a long nose. Anybody want to help? It's an animal. It's a bit bigger than a sheep. It's a bit... What? Well, near enough. It's a bit bigger than a sheep. No, don't worry, your sister's already on the second one. What? Oh, alpaca. Quick. Well done at the back there. You did well to see that from there. Amazing. Have we got it on the screen? Well, keep going. Alpaca llama. We're on the second one now. It's a type of fish. Okay, just helping out. Okay, it's a type of fish. Whoops. It does. Come on, quick. Oh, we're on the second one here. Oh, I see what we're doing. Yeah. It's a type of fish. I might let you do a little bit of mime. You can do... They're on the third one. You might be able to do a little mime for it as well. It's a goldfish. Don't be confused by the colour, Richard. Fish. And we're on the third one now. This is a specific part of a plant that I'm looking for, a particular plant. Okay. Oh, I mean, it's an amazing... Show on the... That's an amazing model. Anybody want to shout out? It's a pufferfish. Go. Okay, Richard, you're just a little bit behind. You can still make this up. Here we go. What could that be? Oh, we've got to win it! Oh, did you say it as well? I think we could go for like a nice Christian draw, couldn't we? And say everybody's a winner. But actually I heard the words come out of this mouth first. So the leader for most of the game finishes second. But there's no shame in second. It's not like it's last. And over here we've got a winner because it was actually an apple seed. Now how tricky is that to do? Give him a clap. Well done. You know me, get your prize later. I'll remove this from the scene. And who's coming now? Here she comes, Becca.
That was a lot of fun. It's song time again. Now, we're going to watch a video of a new song. It's one that we've never sung in church before. It's one that's got a bit tricky. There's some tricky words in there. But it's a lot of fun. And shake your shakers. Wavy ribbons, and we will enjoy the song together, but don't feel the need to stand up and join in. I certainly won't be. I'm going to go and sit over there. But it's a great song, and it really talks about all what we've talked about this morning. So if we could press play on that, Ivor, that would be brilliant.
is just great. I've never heard that one before. I'm glad we weren't asked to sing it, though. It would have been a fast one there. And for you guys who did escape me, not having me help you with that, because that was rubbish. And to the Wild Woman of Wales, all I'll say is Ireland. And when we have Ole service, we just use the word teaspoon for our prayers, because a teaspoon is abbreviated to TSP, which stands for thank you, sorry, and please. So the first verse that was read to us this morning says, in the beginning God created the heavens and the earth. And throughout the chapter, it keeps saying, and God saw that it was good, until the bit that Curtis did read for us, which said it was very good. So we have a God who is good. And we have a lot of people we support around the world, and this Sunday our mission link is an organisation called IPASC. So we pray for them working in the DRC, the Democratic Republic of Congo. We thank you that their main funder, Bread for the World, has declared its continued support for the work and has provided the funds to rent two homes for them to use as offices so they can continue their work, and for two new motorbikes. They do a lot of work out in the community. We thank you that the students have temporary accommodation to continue their studies. But Father, we're sorry for the disputes that there are out there in the DRC between groups who should know better, but continue to cause major problems, and means that the IPAS site is closed at the moment. Please forgive those who are in dispute. Help them to resolve their difficulties and their differences. Watch over them and support the students, we continue to pray, as they study under very difficult circumstances. As we think of the world in which we live, we thank you, Heavenly Father, for the world you have created and for all the wonderful things we can see, pretty much in that song we just read, sung together. Sunrise and sunsets, deep valleys and tall mountains, beautiful waterfalls and crashing waves, colourful small flowers and huge ancient trees. We're sorry, though, for the way we have treated our world, for the smoke and the pollution we create, the plastic waste that litters our seas, clogs our rivers, for the rubbish we see thrown down in our streets and in the countryside. Please forgive us and help us to treat this world as very precious and special, because it's the only one we've got. Please help us to think about all of our actions so that we seek to do the things that would mean we treat our world with care and respect. As we think of the country we live in, we thank you that today marks a very significant day for the Queen, who celebrates her Platinum Jubilee, marking 70 years as Queen. So today we thank you for her life and service, and for all in government and positions of authority who are called to serve our nation. But we're sorry that for many the role is not about service, but about gaining power and influence. And so often they use their position for things that do not benefit those they serve. Please forgive them. Help them to recognize that they're called to serve others before serving themselves, and remind us that this is also what you ask us to do. As we think of our community, we thank you for all our doctors, nurses, our emergency service workers, those in the caring sector, for our teachers, and all whose work helps us in our day-to-day lives. We're sorry that we so often take these people for granted and do not give them the respect they deserve. Please forgive us and help us to do all we can to support those at a time when morale and staff levels are low. We pray that you would give them strength and wisdom for each new challenge. And as we think of our church, we thank you for all those who lead the many different groups that are available here every week. For those who work for the church and who volunteer to meet and greet all who come in every day. Thank you for all the time and energy they give to all that they do. We're sorry that we don't perhaps pray for the work that all these people undertake, and that as members of the church we have a role to play. As we know, Father, prayer changes things. Please help us to be more aware of what's happening and to be prayerful, even if we aren't able to physically be present. Lord, we pray for all who are ill. So we pray for Joyce McCarthy and Kristen Long, for Joyce Tomlinson and Peter Hinson. For those, Father, who've been bereaved, we pray your support and your comfort for the family and friends of Sheila Morris. And Father, we have a thank you for the life of Henry Burgess and all his family. We don't have a sorry here, but we just have a please. Help them as they
support him in his early days and later days, to know your blessing, to know their love and support, and the tenderness that comes in loving someone precious to us. And Lord Jesus, help us to remember that all you created was good. We're sorry for the things we do, say, and think that spoil our world and our friendships. Please help us to remember that you have promised to be with us and help us every day. Amen. And we always join together by saying the Lord's Prayer, which should appear on the screen. And so I invite you all to join with me in saying this. So together we say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Just one or two things to mention before we close our service with a prayer. Refreshments will be served at the end of our service this morning. They will be brought to you where you are in your seats. Please don't congregate all by the refreshments table, but the team will bring them out to you. If you prefer not to stay for refreshments, that's quite all right. But it'll be nice to greet you on the door on the way out. Next week, the 13th of February, there's a few changes to be mindful of. Refreshments from next week at this service at 10:30 are going to be served down in the atrium area, down the corridor. So for next Sunday, from next Sunday, after our morning 10:30 service, we'll be having refreshments down the corridor. Two other things to be mindful of for next Sunday. If you are coming to the 8:45 service in the morning or the 6 o'clock service in the evening, you no longer need to book ahead to come along to those services. You can just come, and even if you haven't booked for those two services, we're encouraging booking for the 10:30 still and for the 11 o'clock down at the centre as well. So keep booking for those services, but the early 8:45 and the evening 6 p.m. from next week, you don't need to book. You'd be very welcome just to come and join us as we gather together. And one other thing is to say that this evening we're really looking forward to Bishop Mark Tanner coming to Sundays at 7 as we hear him tell his story in an informal interview setting here. Refreshments from 6:30, the interview will start at 7 in the church. Numbers for that are quite full, which is fantastic. It means that there's less space for walk-ins, but you can come and there'll be an overflow space in the hall. So if you feel that you'd not be like to be too tightly packed, you'd like to distance a bit more, there will be space in the hall as well where the interview will be relayed through. Fantastic. I'm going to close with a prayer from one of the letters in the Bible. So let's just pray. Now to God, who is able to do immeasurably more than all we ask or imagine, according to his power that is at work within us, to him be glory in the church and in Christ Jesus throughout all generations, forever and ever. Amen. Amen. Thank you so much for joining us this morning. I hope you enjoy some refreshments. Do stay to chat and catch up as well. Thank you.
Our God is great. steeper than a submarine. He's higher than the universe and beyond my wildest dreams. And he's known me and he's loved me since before the world began. How wonderful to be a part of God's amazing plan. A great big God,